If I could tell you only one thing. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. A few years ago, I was asked to give a short talk about computer security. I was given 5 or 10 minutes, which forced me to distill exactly what I think about when I think about computer security. The way I approached it was to think to myself, if someone walked away from my 5-minute talk remembering only one thing, what would that one thing be? I gave the talk, I was invited back a second time, so I repeated the process. If I could have you remember only two things I say about computer security, what would those two things be? I gave that talk, and it led me to another talk about 5 things in priority order. Today I want to give you that list in reverse order, a kind of a top 5 list of what I would tell you if I could tell you only one thing, or 5 things. Number 5, keep learning. Now, I mean this in a couple of different ways. Of course, it means to keep learning about how to use your computer and technology, but more important, when it comes to security, it means to keep abreast of what's happening. Stay open to security or computer-related news. You don't need to understand the current threats and vulnerabilities in detail, but hearing about current tech security issues will help keep you more aware and secure. A good example right now is paying attention to the various types of scams that are currently making the rounds. Just hearing about them will help you avoid them if they ever cross your paths. A good resource is The Perfect Scam podcast from AARP. Number 4, be patient. So many people are in a rush to get something done that when they encounter a problem, they blow right through it, often making the wrong choices when it comes to their computer security. Take the time to do a little research or ask a question and get an answer. That patience will save you a lot of grief in the long run. Spending a little time up front can often save you a tremendous amount of time later if things go wrong. Number 3, don't panic. I see people make the worst possible choices out of panic. They click on anything, they install or even purchase anything that even hints about solving their problem. Many times, those solutions just make things worse, often much worse. Don't panic. Think it through. There's very little you can do that will permanently physically damage your computer, so just be okay with it. Take your time. Don't panic. Calm down enough to read error messages, make notes about what happened and in what order. Number 2, be skeptical. I know we all want to assume the best of humanity, and mostly we can. But when it comes to promises made by software vendors, pop-ups, or unsolicited phone calls, absolutely question the source. Make sure you understand where the information is coming from. See if you can't corroborate with some other information from an already trusted source. And yes, that means you should invest some time developing trusted sources. People you can reach out to locally or online resources you know you can rely on to steer you straight. Number 1. This one should be obvious if you followed me at all. Backup. The most important tip I have for computer security actually surprises people because it doesn't feel like a security thing at all. Backup. Backup your data. Backup your computer. Things are going to happen. Hardware's going to fail. And in the realm of computer security, you're going to miss something. You'll end up with malware or ransomware or a virus of some sort. You can protect yourself against all of these things and more with a good backup in place. For example, if you get malware or even ransomware, you restore to the previous backup you took the night before, and the malware is gone. It's like it never happened. How much more secure and stress-free can you be? There you have it. 5 fairly simple concepts to help you stay safe. If you remember only one, sure, remember to back up. But hopefully, though, you'll remember all 5. And of course, I'm going to be here to remind you. For updates, for comments, for links to related topics and more, visit askleo.com/22985. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.